Bref, bref.
What's up, y'all? Mike Dub here. I want to do a vlog. Excuse the beat. We got a thunderstorm going on.
This is Dia with the forecast weather. It is hailing outside. Just earlier, it was about, 80-some degrees.
Want to do a vlog on my moving head setup with the lights that I already have. Had a couple of DJs ask me what kind of poles I use and what mounts that I use to mount the moving heads on. So thought I'd do a little video on it. A little tired today. We had some community service with the church. Wrapping up the end of Love Week. Basically, we planted a bunch of trees and bushes and made a walkway and assembled some benches or whatnot. Me and the kids and I think it was about 50 church members. Shout out to Hope Church, by the way. Back to what I was saying. I'd kind of show you my general setup on, you know, how I have it in the cases and the things that I bought to mount the lights on top of the speaker stands that I use. All right, so I bought me some moving heads. I've been wanting moving heads since I believe I saw C. Smith with them first that I can remember. They were like $700 at the time, so I'm like, man, $1,400 for some lights. I don't see how they can make me any money, so why would I buy them? Did I want them? Of course, because they look beautiful, nice, you know. But now, these are the 250 IRCs by Chavez. And what made me go ahead and get these are the removable gobo. It's a little door right here that you slide off and you can pop these gobos out. Guess I'll pop one out real quick. Which one did I have loose already? All right, got that. Normally it wouldn't be this hard to get out, but being I'm doing it on camera. All right, yeah. So anyway, here's the little gobo. You can push from this side, the silver side, and there's a little ring inside that's keeping the gobo in, and you can replace it with a custom monogram. So instead of me, well, my situation, I have the American DJ Zoom, or is it the Chavez Zoom? Hold on. Alright, my situation, I have the Chavez Zoom 2.0 gobo, and I think this is like 15 watt LED. It doesn't say it on the house, but I'm pretty sure it's a 15 watt. Alright, so this worked for me for several years. I've made plenty of money with it, selling it to brides and grooms and birthday parties or whatnot. But being that I want a brighter monogram on the wall, more vivid, this is putting out 60 watts compared to the Zoom putting out 15 watts. It's gonna be like night and day. So I can still customize my gobos with my transparencies or send off to get them made. Like I said, I'm not going to pop this out because it's kind of a pain in the butt to get back in. It's doable, don't get me wrong. I just don't feel like doing it on camera. But as I said, push from this side, this little metal ring comes out and that's holding it in place. And then the metal, you know, gobo comes out. You can replace it in. Then all you do to put it back in is point it side in. I need a little bit more light. All right. You know it's in because when you spin it around, the wheel itself, the wheel next to it will spin. So it's back in. Easy breezy. Now I have a custom, well, if I were to put a custom one in, I would have had a custom monogram to shine on the wall or the floor during like the dinner and the announcements and whatever, and then during the party I would probably turn on another gobo, let the lights go, and then maybe towards the end of the night, or if they're taking pictures or something, where, you know, I can, if I notice I want to put the monogram back on the wall or on the dance floor or whatever during a special dance, I can. So that was my reason for getting Movin' Heads. More vivid monogram. You can customize the gobos in here now, and they're easy to get to. You don't have to take the whole shell apart. I can spotlight the couple coming in the room. I can spotlight the first dance now. I can spotlight any speaker. And I ordered this remote control. This just came in. That's another reason why I'm putting these up, because I want to play with the remote control and see what all it's capable of doing. If I don't want to bring out my second computer and run, you know, my DMX 2.0, I have the remote control, so I can, you know, control the moving heads with the remote control without having to worry about, you know, DMXing them together. Or I will probably DMX them together, those two, the slave master mode, and then be able to run one of them off of the remote control. So I can, you know, if I want the room to strobe, or if I want to spotlight, you know, whoever it is I want to spotlight, I can. So that's the reason why, another reason why I am putting these back on the poles today. Alright, this is the general way I plan on storing my lights and, you know, transporting them with the case, Chave case. And these are the brackets I bought. I will try to put a link in the description, but I bought them on eBay. They came black. I don't know if you can see. I painted them white. I also had to drill some holes, or make the holes longer, wider, however you want to look at it, with the drill bit. I think the factory holes stopped about right there, and I, you know, put them on the back of the lights, marked them, and of course drilled them out. And these are going to be, let me zoom in on the speaker stands, that I will mount them on. So this is what they'll sit on, and I'm going to bolt them on, and I'll show you that. Alright, so here's the light. The front of the light has the little screen on it where it gives you the, you know, LCD readout of what you're doing. And the back of the light has the power plugs, DMX ins and outs. At least that's how I'm going to set mine up. Alright, so I went to Home Depot and got me a combination of bolts. I've been playing with them so much I got them tightened. Alright, so I think this is a 1/4-inch bolt, not sure. Regular washer and a lock washer. Alright, so from previously mounting this, I'm going to put the knob to the back. So obviously the crowd won't see the knob. Not that I doubt they'll notice it anyway, but hey, it's just me being me.
Come on.
So everything worked out good as planned. Well, it worked out as planned. Lock washer on top, so I won't have to worry about having a wrench at the top to hold the bolt in place. And I'll mount this on top of the pole. All right, so when I ordered the lights, I ordered some scrims to go along with them. These are on stage. There's some three-way speaker scrims. I don't know if you can see that, so that's all the way in the shot or not. My only gripe about these is the pockets that the feet are go into. They're not all that deep. The thing I do like about these, the price, I think they're only $30. Could be wrong, maybe they're $39. The price and the bag that they go into to keep them clean and whatnot while you're storing them is built onto the scrim, so you be hard for you to lose the bag because it's on the scrim. Velcro strap, you won't have to buy another clip or anything, and it has this like rubber rich felt fabric sewed to the strap. And yeah, just trying to see the total setup, how it's going to look for a wedding. Show you a little time lapse of how long it takes me to put this on, being that the pockets are so shallow. They're very shallow. Being that I made some of these from, you know, buying fabric at the fabric store, they definitely could have done this differently, but hey, it is what it is. I do fly my speakers kind of high. My concept of that is the higher I have my speaker, the better chance the sound will fill the room and not be ate up by, you know, bodies. Alright, so I do have these mounted now. Let me back up so you can see how they look with the scrim. I got the power running to this one. Came out power to that one. Same with the DMX. And right now they're in master slave mode. Master slave. And these have three or four different slave modes where they don't have to pattern each other exact. Right now they're patterning each other exact because there's no music on. I have them on music active mode. Let me see here. If I can find the music to put on. Alright, I don't want to let this run too long because of course the copyrights and whatnot. But as you see, they are running in like polar opposites and then they'll match. But yeah. Enough of that. Now it's time to see how this remote's going to work. So I'm going to go over here to my master. This is my first time doing this, so y'all bear with me. It's in sound. I want to put it into I don't know if you can see that. IR mode. I'm sure you saw it. So now, supposedly, I have control over it. So let's hit red. Okay, it's changing with the remote. I just have to figure out. See, I hit auto and I hit sound. Let's see, blackout. Lights off with the remote. All right, so let's hit strobe. I guess I gotta turn black off out. Strobe. So 18 and they're strobing. And of course I'm slowing it down or I can speed it up. I don't know if you can really tell how much it's strobing. But yeah. So the remote works fine. I just have to figure out what all functions and what all settings to do to make them do whatever the remote does. But yeah, this is the Chave IRC remote. It's hard to kind of keep everything in focus and keep the camera in your hand. But yeah, here we go. Here's the remote working with the lights. And that's going through a color wheel right now. Four, and I'll switch it to blue, five. So that's one. This is two. Just hitting the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or whatever. I guess these are like the different auto. So what I want to get into more is how to be able to manually control so I can pan or tilt on the YX axis and be able to control it from the remote. So that's the next thing I'll be working on. But yeah, $20 investment. If I don't want to hook them up DMX and I want to be able to control them, the IRC remote comes in handy. All right, so that's all I got for the moving heads and the IRC remote and the scrims. I will check and see how it looks when I put my mini Kentas on them. Probably lower the scrims a little bit and mount the mini Kentas on, and that's about it. All right, so yeah, next video is I got my Samsung SSD hard drive in, as well as the cradle. I'm going to leave the factory hard drive in and you just use it as like a backup drive, or like just a second drive. I'm not going to raid them and stripe them or anything like that. I think this will make the system a lot faster by itself. I still put all my music on my external drive. This is just basically for boot up speed and I getting into Adobe programs, and just want, you know, make sure I have enough speed to function. So that'd be the next video. Until then, peace out, and remember,
love yours. Love yours.